In human evolution, it goes in fits and starts. You know, sometimes everybody knows what's happened. You know, we evolved into Australopithecus, some ape evolved into Australopithecus, or Australopithecus evolved into Homo habilis evolved into Homo erectus evolved into Homo neanderthalensis, and then Neanderthals evolved into humans. That, when I was a student, that was roughly what everybody, you know, what you were told happened. And of course, it's nice and simple. I think we're going through a stage now where there is a lot of sort of tension between the people who still think it's nice and simple and people who think it's actually complicated. And that because it's complicated, and the other thing, the other interesting bit of science that's relevant to human evolution is the discovery, now people are using genetic evidence to look at relationships of living animals. They are discovering that relationships which are supported by the genetic evidence are not necessarily supported by the morphological evidence you can see. So what this means is that shared morphology does not always mean shared ancestry, shared immediate ancestry. And the name for that is homoplasy, which is morphology which is found in two animals, which is not inherited from their most recent common ancestor. In other words, they look alike not because they share a recent common ancestor. So there is more and more evidence of that in the animal kingdom. And if there's more and more evidence of that occurring in the animal kingdom, it seems to me there's absolutely no reason why that didn't occur in our own evolution. Now, if that occurred in our own evolution, it means that things that look alike are not necessarily closely related. And so the ways that Ardipithecus resembles later hominins might not mean that Ardipithecus is closely related to later hominins. It might mean that Ardipithecus just happens to have morphology which has evolved more than once, and that morphology is telling you, you think it's telling you about relationships, but it's not telling you about relationships. So all this evidence is coming from all sorts of studies of all sorts of animals, and I think that is science that's relevant to human evolution. I don't think a lot of my colleagues appreciate that, but I think in 5 or 10 years time, I think it will be apparent that homoplasy is real. It's not, higher primates are not excluded from homoplasy, and homoplasy complicates reconstructing relationships, and we better get used to it. You know, so I think, it's unlikely you're going to find ancestors in any case. And B, even if you think you've found an ancestor, it's probably not an ancestor. So for the folks who are on the ancestor hunt, I think it's going to be a tough decade or so, probably. Okay. But, you know, it'll be interesting.
Thank you so much. Thank you again.